So in the UK we call them threadworms, and in the US they call them pinworms. But they're the same thing. Let's learn more about them and how to treat them. Now threadworms are tiny worms that are in your poo, and they're quite easy to spot because they look like tiny little white threads. What I'll do as well is I'll leave a link in the description below for you in case you're unsure on how to spot them. Also, check this scenery out. Now you may also see them around your child's bottom area, and the other symptoms include extreme itching, especially around the anogenital region, irritability and waking up during the night. So that's a little background about these pesky worms. Now let's move on to treatment and hygiene measures, but let's do that somewhere else because, well, it's actually really cold here. Now treating threadworms is very simple, but remember, every household member must be treated even if they have no symptoms. I know it's more difficult, but remember, threadworms are very contagious and easily spread, so it has to be done. The main medication used to treat threadworms is called mebendazole. Now you don't need a prescription for it, and it's available from any pharmacy, but I would recommend that you have a short consultation with the pharmacist so they can make sure that you're suitable to take it and to also give you some useful tips. Now there are some situations where you should see a doctor. So for instance, if you get frequent reoccurrences, if you're pregnant, breastfeeding, or if it's for a child under the age of 2. So mebendazole works by stopping the threadworms from absorbing sugar. Now the medication is 90 to 100% effective, but it doesn't kill the eggs, which is why strict hygiene measures are required afterwards. And we're going to discuss this a bit further on. Also, these props have absolutely nothing to do with today's video. I just put them here so it would look a bit more clinical. Now, there is some debate in the medical literature if a second dose of mebendazole should be routinely taken 14 days after the initial dose. However, CKS recommends that a second dose should only be repeated if the infection persists. So that's the end of treatments, but please remember that strict hygiene measures should be followed for at least 2 weeks after being treated with mebendazole, or at least 6 weeks if you're doing hygiene measures alone. Now let's run through them. Tip 1. Wash your hands thoroughly with warm soapy water after using the toilet or changing nappies, and also before you make any food. Tip number 2. Cut your fingernails regularly, avoid biting them, and also avoid scratching around the anus. Tip 3. Shower every morning and make sure you pay particular attention around the bottom and the anus area. This is to help remove the eggs from the skin. Tip 4. Change bedding and nightwear daily, and also make sure you wash them, your clothes, your towels in a hot cycle. It's also important not to shake everything around the room as it can distribute the eggs everywhere else. Tip 5. Dust and vacuum your rooms frequently, and even vacuum your mattresses. To clean your bathroom and kitchen, it's all about damp dusting the surfaces, but make sure you wash the cloth frequently in hot water. Tip 6. Make sure that everyone in the house has their own towel, and also with toothbrushes, keep them in a closed cupboard and rinse thoroughly before you use them. And that's the end of the video. I hope my tips help you, and I've also left more information in the description below, which I'd strongly advise everyone to read. See you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.
It really is an amazing view. I mean, I wish I had one of these yachts. That would make it even better. If we had a yacht, I would film on the yacht and maybe get seasick because we get bad seasickness. If you do get seasick, watch my How to Stop Motion Sickness video. You'll love it. You will love it. Tip number 2. If I could remember, it'd be great. There's a lot of helicopters and planes flying past. I think LAX is like that way. Typical landing. Not good for filming.